Hello, good afternoon. Yes, 1201. Good afternoon, everybody. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Andy Sohn. I am the Vice President of Marketing and Relations at Church Extension Fund. I'm going to keep moving, so Jeff's got to follow and pan me. Here we go. Anyway, like Travis said, we've done a lot to support Lutheran churches and schools, especially throughout this last 5 months in the COVID pandemic. You know, as I was listening to your the last session, I only caught the last 15 minutes, but I do not envy what you have to do. You guys are really doing God's work here, and we're very thankful that you are out here. People are being thoughtful. The principals are really doing everything they can to be able to have Lutheran schools operate here in the next month. And why is that so important? Well, because we know that what you're doing is a ministry, that God's word is being shared with children that don't know Jesus. And that's what's most important about all of this. In a time when we're thinking about our own mortality and kids are having these conversations with their parents, learning about all the scary stuff, Jesus is really needed right now, and it's really important what you do. So we're just very thankful that we have such a great group of people here in the Michigan District that can help support Lutheran schools, that are committed to the ministry of what Lutheran schools do. So everybody, just thank you. Give yourselves a round of applause for doing what you do. We're very thankful for that. So I wanted to bring up a couple of things. One, I think I sent it about 10 days ago, so you should have received a mailing with for a letter from me about what Church Extension Fund is doing. It's called our COVID line of credit. We had one of our board members recently who works for the Lutheran High School Association talk about, she said, well, you know, we've had to buy $250,000 worth of PPE, masks, hand sanitizer, all sorts of stuff that wasn't in our budget. And we thought, wow, well, you know, we didn't really think about that when we rolled this line of credit out in April. We didn't think we would have to be here at this point in August, September. What that line of credit is, and it's explained in the letter that I sent, basically it's a way for you to borrow some money from Church Extension Fund at a very low rate. Right now it's a 1% below our going rate, so it's somewhere below 3%. So I think it's like 2.75 or 2.85 maybe. Anyway, it's a really good rate. It's a really cheap way to borrow money to buy for those PPE expenses that you weren't expecting. And by way of example, a $25,000 line of credit at that rate would probably take a monthly payment of about $60. So, you know, if you do have these expenses you're looking at, maybe we should provide masks or, you know, plexiglass or whatever. That is an opportunity for you to borrow from us at a very good rate. It's a one year, and it can also be rolled into a long-term loan as well, too. So that's something that we have available to you if everyone is looking for a way to provide that for students and teachers and safety and whatnot. Secondly, we also have a security grant. Raise your hand if your school has taken advantage of Church Extension Fund security grant. See a couple back here. What'd you do with it? Cameras. Who here needs more cameras in their building? I'm sure lots of you. What Church Extension Fund is doing is we're offering a $2,500 grant for you to provide security for your people, not necessarily to protect property, but to protect the people there from others that may have, you know, may want to do them ill. So that's the idea. We did suspend it the first for 2 months during the lockdown. It is going to be extended. We're back accepting applications again. Those will be going on through January 31st of 2021. So as you all are figuring out how to do school right now, it'll give you a little more lead time if you want in order to get that application in. I would encourage you to do it. We've had about 50 churches and schools participate in it so far, and a lot of them are cameras, locks, new doors. I know St. Lawrence did a card system, you know, emergency procedures card system, so you can get creative with it. It's pretty open for that, so if you do see a need at your school, by all means, come talk to us. We're happy to get you some money for that as well, too. Travis has a way of putting me right before lunch, but I have one other thing to say. We actually, Church Extension Fund, entered into a ministry agreement with the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod Foundation, the LCMS Foundation in St. Louis, to help support a gift planner in the district. And that person is very near and dear to one person in this room, as well as Bob Burgess. No, I'm kidding. Come on up, Julie. Julie Burgess is the new district gift planner. So why don't you give her a round of applause?
All right, I'm going to take this off. Hi, I'm Julie Burgess, and yes, I have been on the front lines with your spouses because I've been married to one of you for the last 36 years, and for the last 6 months have been living through this COVID nightmare and supporting and praying for my husband and our school, and Bob Burgess is my husband. So it's an honor and a privilege to serve here in the Michigan District through the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod Foundation and through Church Extension Fund. And so I am the gift planner here. Michigan hasn't had someone in my position here in quite a number of years. Bill Burmeister, many of you might know him. He represented Church Extension Fund and did some of this with gift planning, but I've gone through training and certification for all of this now, so that's my role, and I accepted that call right before COVID hit. So I did all of my training virtual. So as kids were online on computers doing virtual training, that's what I was doing for like 9 hours a day through March, April, May, and most of June. So now I'm getting out and meeting with congregations and meeting with individuals and talking about gift planning. So I know a lot of you, planning and preparation is key for all of you. I know as principals, as administrators, leaders of your schools, you have got to be ready to go for anything. And I want to tell you right now, my heart and my prayers are with you all. This is not an easy job, and you guys do not get thanked enough. I know teachers, you see that where the teachers get thanked and pastors get thanked, and a lot of times people forget about the principals. So from my heart, I just want to tell you thank you, and I will continue to keep praying for you in these months to come, because this is not an easy time. And for some of you, it's a scary time, and it's frustrating, and I just want you to know you have my prayers. And if there is any specific prayer you want to share with me, I left business cards and some information on the table over here, and feel free to take one. You can text me or email me, and I will be your prayer warrior if that's what you need. I do want to share with you what I do as a gift planner is I meet with churches, I meet with congregations and leadership, going in and explaining to them what a gift plan process looks like. It's a four-step process. But also with schools, a lot of times we think, oh, it's for the church, but schools also have their own endowments. You may have your own foundations, and the LCMS Foundation can help you with that as well. We can walk alongside of you and encourage people to give to that and help direct people, because we really feel at the foundation, we feel that God has placed a gift plan on every Christian's heart. And so my role is to sit down with donors, walk them through a gift plan, help them understand by doing a survey, help them understand more about what charitable giving looks like and what that can look like in their lives. And it's not just a one-size-fits-all. I would encourage you to take this brochure, Gift Generosity Plans for Family and Ministry, and this shows you a number of different ideas of gift plans just in a really short little pamphlet here. And then also I want to encourage you to take the ministry report from 2019, and just to see the millions of dollars that the foundation has given away just in 2019 to schools, to churches, to other LCMS ministries, and then to other 501c3s. So I would encourage you just to kind of educate yourself on that. Take one of my business cards, and if you know of people or if you would like me to come and visit with your school, with your congregation, I would be happy to do that. That's what I'm doing right now, getting out and meeting with people, either virtual or face-to-face, and setting these things up and helping people walk alongside of them, helping them get their gift plans going for their congregations and building those endowments so that we can be better preparers and better planned for these types of, you know, just with COVID. We all know what we've gone through financially and with emotionally and spiritually with all of this, and to be planning now for the next one is really a good thing to be doing. And so if any of you have any questions, I'm going to actually be staying for lunch. I'll get to eat lunch with my husband, and I'll be sticking around for a little bit. So if you want to just come up and introduce yourself to me, I'd love to meet you. If you have any questions for me, feel free to stop by and share those with me as well. But it's great to be here, and I am not going to keep you any longer because I know everyone's hungry, and you want to get up and move those feet. So thank you so much, and God's blessings on the rest of your day. Thank you.